Good afternoon, dear Presidium, dear colleagues. As of today, the necessity of conservative treatment in second and further stages of non-small cell lung cancer is of no doubt. If we sum up what had been said today, the standard today is 2-3 cycles of platinum doublets prior to operation, or 3-4 cycles post-op, based on the results. We have improvement of 5 years survival by 5%. We are the apologize of the neoadjuvant chemotherapy. Many studies have proven that after neoadjuvant chemotherapy, there are not so many complications. 5% of overall survival are certainly not far from ideal results. The expectations are very high in terms of the new methods. 5 years ago, we had a new option, visually immunotherapy, checkpoint inhibitors. Two scientists, James Allison and Tasuku Hanya, received the Nobel Prize for this discovery. And as of today, this method is widely used when treating grade 4 and SCLC. And 5 years survival is improved by 15-20% as of today. In our clinic in the Pulmonology Institute, First Medical University of St. Petersburg, we are dealing with the adjuvant therapy for a long time. I want to commemorate Yuri Levashov, one of our teachers, who back in 1998 created a laboratory of immunocorrection. And this immunocorrection lab in those days was dealing with the immunochemotherapy. Unfortunately, immunologicals in those days were different, interleukins 1 and 2, metabolic correctors, and they did not give much better results in terms of survival, but still it was immunochemotherapy. Now we have a whole group of immunologicals in our store, anti-PD-1, anti-PDL-1, and anti-CTLA-4. These drugs are developed by various pharma companies. All these companies as of today try to run quicker. AstraZeneca, MSD, Pfizer, Novartis, and Russian Biocard, which we hope will launch very soon BCD-100 onto the market that will allow to use immunochemotherapy in Russia. If we speak about the drug of preference, this slide shows the questionnaire of 5 leading experts in the area of lung cancer, which drug they would prefer for the second line, first and second line. All the 5 experts answered differently, with different preferences given to either pembrolizumab or atezolizumab or nivolumab. The clinical trials will show which of the drugs performs better. Standard therapy for non-small cell lung cancer is as follows: nivolumab, nivo, and atezo as standard second-line therapy for the advanced lung cancer, never mind the PD-L1 level. In patients with a high level of PD-L1, more than 50%, monotherapy with Pembro is recommended. Non-squamous cells, non-small cell lung cancer. First line is carboplatin, pemetrexed, and Pembro. Bevacizumab is registered all over the world as a drug that is being used for the therapy of patients after chemo radiotherapy. And today I'm going to tell you about the adjuvant and neoadjuvant therapies. Immunotherapy, it has proven its efficacy in small trials. And we use it in treating our patients. Neoadjuvant immunotherapy studied a little bit better because immediately after induction therapy, we can carry out surgery and assess the efficacy of the therapy from the morphological point of view. And there are many publications in terms of pre-op options. Many studies are carried out with Pembro, Atezo, and different combinations of these drugs. If we look onto the right column, we understand that the results are expected to come out not very soon, 2023, 2026, etc. These trials are aimed to survival, hence we are going to wait several years for the final results. But there are some intermediary results already available that show that the use of either immunotherapy or the combination of immune and chemotherapy may secure regression of the tumor at the level of 60 to 70%. This is certainly great because pre-op pathomorphosis is an indicator of today of the therapeutic efficacy and the indirect result, indirect proof of the survival increase post-op. There are not so many publications as of today, but you may find them in large journals like New England Journal of Medicine. This publication has already become a classical one. 22 patients who had only two nivolumab administrations with 1 week between these administrations, 1 month pre-op period. And as you see, very significant pathomorphosis that is proven on the X-ray. In 9 out of 22 cases, a very good pathomorphological response, 43%. There were similar works with Pembro, second phase study trials, 30 patients, and a similar picture. A patient who had two administrations of Pembro, the interval was 3 weeks, and a very well-pronounced pathomorphosis that was finalized with a successful lung resection. Adjuvant immunotherapy is also very widely studied. The same drugs are used in the adjuvant immunotherapy, and we expect the results of these trials. And maybe the third phase will be waiting for it for 3, 4, 5 years. But certainly not only benefits are expected, but immunological tsunami may happen. All kinds of pneumonitis, hyperprogression is possible. Hence, immunochemotherapy has to be performed by highly experienced specialists who know what to do with complications. In conclusion, one clinical case, very controversial one, but it shows that we have many things to study still in terms of immunotherapy. quite a young patient, but a severe patient with pulmonary and cardiovascular insufficiencies, myoca, squamous cell lung cancer was detected in June 2017. Large mass in the right lung, 2.4 by 2.3 centimeters, and enlarged lymph nodes. The patient was administered to the oncodispensary, and the biopsy was taken. The diagnosis was squamous cell lung cancer, 3A stage. A thoracic surgeon consulted the patient in September 2017. Due to low functional parameters, the surgery was not carried out, and he was referred to the radiologist. Not very quick, from September to January, he was looking for the radiologist. Finally, he got there in January 2018. By that time, the tumor increased in size, 3.2 by 2.9 centimeters, and it spread into segment 6 already, not only present in segment 2, but also spread to the segment 6, and the stage was already 3B. ECOG was 2-3. Radiologist found reasons to refuse the radiotherapy for this patient because it was decided that there was no opportunity to carry out stereotactic radiotherapy while the patient couldn't tolerate other radiotherapies. He was PDL was examined. It was very low, less than 1%, so even platinum doublet was not an option, the only option that was possible was immunotherapy. We started it from February 2018. Up to now, he is receiving it. In March 2018, there was some positive trend already. By December 2018, it was progressing, or the tumor was regressing. As of today, as of the 31st of May 2019, no increase of the tumor size. Regional lymph nodes are not increased. Pneumofibrosis is seen. The question is thus, what's to be done with this, such patients further? Similar situation may be seen when we see good regression with target therapy. When the patient's tumor decreases, we understand that complete pathomorphosis took place. Shall we operate him or not? Hence, many questions remain. The main question in immunotherapy is when to start it, prior to operation or after the operation, as a monotherapy or in combination with chemotherapy. These questions do not have complete answers, but we hope that when we receive the data of large clinical trials, we'll be able to define. Well, we'll need surgeons everywhere, at least for the biopsies. Wonderful perspective for the surgeons. The main thing is for the salaries not to go down. I think all of you will agree to deal with biopsies only. Sergey, I have one question. Look, and Evgeny Naumovich arrived. Now adjuvant immunochemotherapy. 3A stage present there as well. The potential of immunotherapy and those who take part in these trials were on the verge when big surgery will be in demand, not only 3E, but 3B maybe. If it is that efficient, then the possibilities for surgeries increase as well. Yes, certainly, what I showed in the last slide was certainly a joke, because having more potent conservative therapy in our hands, immunotherapy to be precise, we can help more patients, not only 3B, but maybe even 4 stage. Certainly, first and foremost with oligometastatic diseases, but the combination may be used pre-op, post-op, 3A, 3B, and some patients fourth grade immunochemotherapy in combination with surgery may provide an opportunity for these patients to live much longer. And even ordinary methods of therapy without surgery show that we have increased survival from 5 to 15, 20%. And sometimes when we have the combination of surgery and radiotherapy for fourth grade, 5 year survival reaches 30 and 40% there. So we have a more potent weapon now, and thus we alleviate the life of the surgeons in terms of improving their overall survival. Thank you, Sergey. I join your words and would like to answer the question of Evgeny more briefly. One of the main tasks of neoadjuvant conservative treatment is a period of non-resectable into resectable form, and that's what we expect.